Welcome everybody, thanks for assisting to this new webinar about the automatic fault extraction. I'm Jean-Philippe Adam, I'm geophysicist and portfolio manager Europe for ELIS, and I will present you this new tool available in PaleoScan 2019. I will start with a short PowerPoint presentation and then I will switch to live demo. Okay, just to start, make a short presentation. This is the schedule of the PowerPoint presentation. I will show you the current the method available in PaleoScan 2018 based on the variance, and then I will present you the new method to automatically extract some fault and how we extract some fault, and also how we edit and merge this automatic fault extraction, and then some conclusion. Okay, just to start, what is available on PaleoScan 2018. This is a seismic. This dataset comes from Australia. It's Exmouth dataset, northwestern Australia. And then first, what we can compute? We can compute what we call a vector field. In fact, for each pixel, we compute the deep and azimuth of each pixel, and then we compute the normal of this pixel. It's all the arrow you can see on the screen. And we obtain, if I zoom, this kind of attribute, okay, based on the deep and azimuth of all the events. And we can use this to compute some variance, for example, based on this vector field attribute. And then, okay, this attribute is very useful to detect at least the main fault, but okay, like this, you can copy, you can pick some fault manually, but it's difficult to highlight all the fault. As you can see, we have some fault on this part, not visible with this attribute. Okay, just switch to time slice view. Okay, again, it's very good to see the main structural events. Okay, like this, and then based on this attribute, we can compute the maximum of this attribute on the windows, okay, to compute this kind of result. And we obtain this kind of attribute, okay, the color bar is from blue to red. Red means I have a very high confidence on the fault occurrence. And then, okay, I will switch again in inline direction. If I just display the picked fault, okay, it's a good attribute to highlight a structural event, but we have very high variability on the fault plane. Due to this, it's not possible to extract automatically the fault from this attribute. We have to find another attribute, okay, because we are not exactly located on the fault. Due to this, we have worked on a new method for PaleoScan 2019. It's what we call the best fault plane method. Okay, I will describe just on this part. Okay, we start from the work of DevL from Colorado School of Mines. Okay, the DevL work on the fault likelihood. The likelihood, the maximum likelihood, is the minimum of variance. In fact, on the seismic, you rotate a disk in different directions for deep and azimuth to find the minimum of semblance. And then, thanks to this attribute, we obtain from the seismic, we obtain three different outputs: the fault likelihood, we highlight the fault, the deep, and the azimuth. Okay, we start from this way of fault extraction, but then we adapt this algorithm to fit with our existing attribute and our on our way to compute attribute to be more efficient on the fault computation. And due to this, we create what we call the fault best plane method. In fact, from the seismic, we compute the variance I showed you just before. But then, exactly as the fault likelihood method, we rotate the disk in different directions, deep and azimuth, to find the maximum of variance to obtain the what we call the fault best plane. Okay, first thing, with this attribute, we obtain only one attribute as output, the fault best plane. And this is the example for the full volume. Okay, I have all my volume, each square is a pixel. Okay, I will just focus on one pixel. I can rotate in different deep direction, and like this, I can rotate the disk. And for each disk, as you can see, this disk is higher than it's bigger than one pixel. Okay, it's a parameter, and this disk is It's bigger vertically than horizontally. And then, inside the disk, we compute a Gaussian sum of the variance. And then, for each couple of deep and azimuth, okay, like this, we rotate deep and azimuth and all the direction. We compute the variance, the sum of the variance, and we find the maximum value for all the couple deep azimuth. And like this, we obtain the maximum, depending the number of orientation, of this Gaussian sum. And like this, okay, from the seismic, we compute an optimized variance. We rotate the disk, and inside the disk, we just keep the maximum of variance using deep and azimuth. And like this, we obtain the full base plane. But this one, it's not enough to extract the fault because we have more than one pixel. I will show you just after during the live demo. We have to compute the extrema of this fault plane. It's what we call the thin fault plane. And like this, we can extract some fault patch using this attribute. And then the final result after filtering, addition, etc., etc. I will just show you just after. Okay, this is again XMOOS dataset. Okay, this is the variance. I will just display in time slice. Okay, and then okay, we divide in different bin like this, and we choose angle from minus to plus 70 degree for the deep, and we compute. We rotate the disk on all the direction. Okay, we have to move from one pixel to another one like this, and then we compute the maximum of variance inside the disk. Just concerning the computation, for the full volume, it's very complex computation. We have to compute from the seismic the variance and then rotate the disk. The computation is approximately half an hour per gigabyte. And then, okay, I just move for all the pixels. We obtain this kind of attributes. It's what we call the full base plane. Okay, exactly as the attribute I show you straight from the variance. It's exactly the same. Red means I have a maximum probability to have a fault. And like this, I highlight very well all the fault and all the structural events. But then, exactly as I explained, it's not possible to extract directly the fault plane from this attribute because we have more than one pixel. Due to this, we have to extract the extrema of this attribute thanks to the Steger algorithm. And like this, we obtain the thin base plane. We obtain this kind of attribute. Okay, in inline direction. And from this attribute, we can extract the fault. Okay, just one comment. I will show you during the live demo, but we split all the workflow. Okay, if you want, you can directly extract the fault from the seismic, but we split the workflow for each attribute. Okay, if you just want to compute the fault base plane and stop to test different parameters, it's possible. Then, from your base plane, you can compute only the thin base plane using different attributes to find the maximum. And then you can extract the fault from the thin fault base plane. Also, just one point before to show you the fault extraction. If you have some custom attributes in-house, custom attributes would look like this attribute, you can also use to extract the fault from your attribute. Okay, and then we scan inline and cross-line direction to find the perpendicular direction of the fault, okay, to have an extraction, a better extraction using this direction, and we extract some unit patch of fault. As you can see, it's exactly as our Horizon automatic tracker. We create some patch of faults from the model grid. We extract some patch of horizon, and then we will connect all this patch of fault all together. And then, yes, it's the fault patch extraction. We extract all this unit patch of fault, and then, depending the deep and azimuth, we try to connect many faults all together, okay, like this to obtain main fault. As you can see, exactly as our again as our Horizons auto tracker, if we have a big change of deep and azimuth, PaleoScan will create another fault because it's easier to connect two faults all together than to correct a fault here is a part of the fault. Due to this, okay, we just, it's a top view, we just look at the different dip and azimuth and connect the fault all together to have main fault connected automatically. And then, this is the same example, this is all the faults automatically extracted by PaleoScan. But we don't extract only fault plane. In fact, for each fault, we create the fault plane and we create some fault stick. And because we have some fault stick, for example, I will just play with this fault, okay, in 3D also. Then I can edit the fault. This is my fault plane. I can erase or I can add some point to edit my fault. Okay. Again, exactly our Horizons automatic solution thanks to the model grid. Okay, we have now an automatic solution for the automatic fault extraction, but the user has the full control of his interpretation. Okay, because it's a software, and even if this extraction is really interesting and very good, it's really important for the user to have the full control of this interpretation and has the capability to change this automatic, okay, by addition, by merging, by splitting. All these tools will be available. Also, just a small part, this is the example I will show you during the live demo. Okay, it's Xmooth. PaleoScan extract around 1,000 faults automatically, okay, around half an hour. This is with the seismic invariance and them with the fault plane, and them in 3D. This is all the faults, but them, also, what it's interesting, I have all the tools of PaleoScan to manage this fault. First of all, I can do some directional filtering. I can filter by dip, azimuth, for example. This is okay. This is my volume with the seismic and the base plane. And then all the fault extract automatically. But I can use the different kind of tool of PaleoScan to filter by size, by dip, by azimuth. For example, in this case, we have created three different fault sets, blue, red, and yellow. And just by playing with the dip and azimuth, I can create different fault sets. For example, the blue fault, it's northeast fault direction. And I can create the fault set. I can save this fault set to then play and use this fault set for the model grid or for some structural framework, for example. Just short conclusion, and then I will switch to live demo. First of all, we have a new method and to extract some fault automatically. It's a three-step method based on the variance. In fact, from the variance, we create what we call a fault base plane. Okay, it's a 3D scan of the variance to find the maximum of variance inside a disk. And then we have to extract the extrema of this fault base plane. It's what we call the thin base plane. It's corresponding to the fault breakpoint. And then we have some fault patch extraction using labeling process. One thing, it's a new way to extract some fault. We have some good result, and it work with many different seismic. We try on different seismic, land acquisition, marine acquisition, this kind of thing. But then what is interesting is we have them all the tool to merge to also control this automatic fault extraction. Again, it's a software. In 90% of the case, it will give you a very good result. But when we need to have an interpreter to really understand the geology, the structural framework, you have the full control to filter, to merge, to edit the fault to really fit with your geology. Okay, it's really important for us to have a software with a full access to interpreter. Okay, it's not only automatic solution. In fact, it's more semi-automatic process where the user has the full control of this interpretation. Okay, I will just after switch in live demo. This is the presentation of my live demo. I will start with the base plane fault method, and then I will show you the fault extraction and all the fault management. Okay, it's more or less the same presentation as PowerPoint, but in live demo. Okay, I will just switch to PaleoScan. This is my dataset. Okay, it's Xmooth dataset. As I explained, it's northwestern Australian dataset. And as you can see, we have many fault, especially on the reservoir level, just on this part. And first of all, okay, we want to extract some fault automatically. As I explained, during this process, we compute different attributes. Due to this, under the attribute tab of PaleoScan, you will have a new pull-down option for automatic fault extraction with three different options corresponding to the three different steps I present you during the PowerPoint. Or you have also access to the automatic fault extraction under the fault specific toolbar. You have a new button for automatic, and then you have the three different steps. I will start from the seismic, okay, from the beginning. This is an attribute view, and then I just have to drag and drop my seismic. Okay, I will just compute a preview during the time of computation. I can explain the attribute. Okay, for the base plane, I need two different parameters. The first one is the window size. The window size is the size, the vertical size of the windows of the disk to find the maximum of variance inside the disk. This is the vertical windows. For the horizontal windows, we divide by two the size of the disk, and then we rotate the disk on different deep and azimuth to find the maximum of variance inside the disk with the Gaussian sum. Just to reduce the computation time, you can enter a minimum deep, okay, because if we scan all the deep, it will be much more longer. Then, depending of your seismic, you can reduce or increase, depending your time and your seismic, the minimum deep for the scanning. And then, we obtain this attribute. I can cross-navigate. Okay. And as you can see, PaleoScan highlights very well all the structural events, okay, even the secondary faults, like this. But then, if I play with the parameter, okay, we just click on, and I zoom. As you can see, I have much more than one pixel. Due to this, it's not possible to extract a fault. We have to compute the extrema of this attribute. It's what we call the scene base plane. If I want, I can create directly from this interface. I will just start the preview and explain the parameter. Just to compute the extrema of this attribute, we just need one parameter. It's the window size. It's the windows to find the local maximum of this attribute to filter this attribute. And then we will obtain a new attribute, the scene fault plane, and we will use this to extract the fault automatically. Okay, take a few seconds because even for the preview, PaleoScan has to compute a small variance and then rotate the disk in different directions and then extract the extrema. It's why the computation is approximately half an hour per gigabyte. And then we obtain this kind of attribute. Okay, we have only one pixel per fault. I can cross navigate just to check this attribute. And then I can use this attribute to extract my 3D fault. I will just focus on this part. I just have to activate the fault extraction. Okay, I click on preview. And then, for the fault extraction, we have different parameters. The first one, it's the minimum window size. It's the minimum size of the fault to extract this fault. Okay, like this, I will not extract very small fault. After, depending the kind of fault you have, you can play with this parameter. Of course, if you want only the major fault, you can increase this parameter. The second one, it's the minimum sinking value. In fact, it's the value, the minimum value to extract the fault from my attributes. Like this, I filter my attribute directly. And then the fault smoothing, okay, to smooth the fault, to have a clean fault using the fault. After, depending the kind of result you want, you can smooth more or less. And then automatically, we obtain all these faults. Okay, for the moment, it's just a preview. But we can extract all these faults automatically from the seismic. Just a few comments. The first one about the fault creation. As I explained, the minimum ceiling value, it's the default parameter, it's linked to our attributes. Okay. If you want to use other attributes, I will show you just after, you have to play with this parameter. And in fact, because it's a three-step method, if I just play, okay, if I toggle off the fault ceiling and the fault extraction, I will only create the fault base plane. I can create only the fault ceiling, base plane and fault ceiling, and I can extract the fault. Like this, I can divide my workflow in different steps. Okay, I start from the seismic, I extract my fault plane, and then when I have my fault plane playing with different parameters to try all the parameters, the size of the disk, the minimum depth, for example, I can use this as input and only compute the ceiling. Okay, like this, I can compute directly the ceiling from the fault base plane, and I can play with different window size. Okay, like this, I will increase the window size just to keep the main fault. Okay, for example. And if I want, I can extract the fault, or I can create different scene fault plane and then extract only the fault. Okay, it's where if you have, okay, like I just have to drag and drop the scene and I can extract the fault. It's where you can play with your custom attributes. Okay, for example, this is the full volume scene fault plane, and if I want, I can extract, okay, some fault automatically. I will just click on run and PaleoScan will extract automatically the fault from this attribute. It's where if you want to use your in-house custom attribute, okay, because you already have this kind of attribute to highlight very well the fault with your custom custom attribute, custom computation with pattern, for example, you can drag and drop your volume, but be careful to this minimum ceiling value. Okay, it's linked to our attributes, our way to compute. Maybe the minimum value to extract the fault, it's not the same. But just by cross-navigating and checking the values you have on the volume, you can play with this attribute to extract your fault from your custom attributes. Okay, and then PaleoScan will extract all the faults straight from the scene fault plane or your custom attribute. It takes a few seconds to extract the fault. First of all, PaleoScan has to create all the unit fault patch and then merge all this patch all together to have an automatic solution. And then, it's the last part of the presentation, I will show you all the tools to manipulate and to handle this kind of result. Okay, because with this kind of result, depending your parameter, you can have many faults. But we have all the interactive tools inside PaleoScan to refine and change this automatic solution thanks to the. And now, okay, PaleoScan extracts all the faults automatically. We will have access. To this fault and display all these faults into the 3D viewer. And then, yeah, automatically, okay, we'll just close this viewer. Automatically, PaleoScan extracts all the faults. I just open my 3D viewer. I drag and drop all the faults to display all the faults automatically extract by PaleoScan. I will open a seismic to have the intersection like this. Okay, just open my seismic and then automatically PaleoScan extract all these faults. I can show you directly in live demo. I have access to all these faults. Okay, I can navigate through my seismic. PaleoScan extract all these faults, and if I switch in time size direction, Okay, I have all these four. First of all, as you can see, especially on the north part, I have some acquisition footprint, and PaleoScan creates some fault on this part. In fact, we have different tools with PaleoScan. First, to filter by size, deep, and azimuth. Okay, I will just zoom in on the seismic, and then with the deep azimuth filter first, I can filter by size. Like this. And I can also filter by deep and azimuth. Okay, for example, if I want to keep only the footprint acquisition, for example, I can keep only this one, or I can just keep the main fault set. For example, I will keep the main fault set. I can still filter by deep and azimuth like this. I can switch again in inline. And then, as you can see, and as I explained during the presentation, for example, PaleoScan creates several faults for this one. If I want, I can select all these faults and I can merge to manually merge all the faults. Okay, for example, I select also these three different faults and I merge. Okay, this is for the manual merging. Or we have one tool to do some fault merge assistance. In fact, PaleoScan will find the best possible merge into the full volume on all the faults displayed by PaleoScan, and then PaleoScan will show me a list of possible faults. Okay, I can make a preview, I can skip, or I can preview and merge all the faults, and like this very quickly I can merge many faults. Okay, of course for the presentation I go very quickly, but of course, okay, you have the full control to preview and then navigate into the seismic to check your merging. Okay, you have the full control of this merging. Okay, it's why you have merge or skip, and like this you can really QC your fault, and like this you can merge very quickly many faults. Also, as I explained during the presentation, we don't extract only fault plane, but we can also extract fault stick. Like this, we have all the stick of the fault. That means I can navigate, and then I can erase some part of the fault from the seismic, but also from the fault plane. And then I can continue the fault. Okay, I can add some stick, I can undo, I can redo. I have all the interactivity of PaleoScan to complete the fault. Okay, the user has the full control of his fault interpretation, and then I just have to press spacebar to validate. And like this, you can directly manage and extract your fault set. And then you can save your fault set. Okay, save as fault set. For example, okay, I just want to save the visible one. I will just put webinar like this. And PaleoScan will save my fault set. And I can use, for example, I can use this fault set directly from the model grid creation. Okay. Just like this, I can drag and drop and use for the model grid creation. Just to point, of course, it depends the kind of work you want to do. If you want to use for structural framework, okay, you have to merge the fault, you have to edit the fault to be sure to have very good fault. If it's for exploration and only for the model grid to stop the automatic propagation using the model grid, because PaleoScan just work on fault plane, it's not mandatory to merge the fault. Okay, and like this, if it's for exploration, you can keep only the main fault with big fault throw, just playing with the size filter, just to keep the main part of the fault, and just use this fault as input for the model grid. Just two points before to end this webinar. We have also, it was not part of the presentation, but we have also implemented two new small tools concerning the faults. The first one, it's you can save fault inside an extraction area. Okay, I don't have an extraction area if I want to create yes. Like this, finish. I can then edit my extraction area Okay, if I just want to keep a part of the fault, okay, I don't want to save all the fault to extract, okay, I can play with the extraction area in 2D and 3D, yes, like this. Okay, for example, I just have to navigate to have the intersection with my extraction area, and then I can play. Okay, it's updating in real time with 2D and 3D, and I can save my fault just inside the extraction area. Okay, I will just remove this object from my 3D object list. And the second one, okay, when you save some faults, PalioScan asks you if you want to save all the faults or only the visible one. Now we have a new tool to just keep the visible one, to remove the hidden fault from the 3D. Okay, if I click, if you have a look on the deep azimuth filter, if I click on yes, I will just keep my visible fault. Like this, even if I initialize all my filter, I will just keep the visible fault. Okay, like this, if it's only the main fault and you want to keep only this one, you remove, and like this, you don't have to save, remove all the objects from the 3D object and drag and drop your fault set again. It's just a small tool to be much more quicker in the fault manipulation. Thank you for your attention, and if you have any question, don't hesitate to send email to our support@elis.fr for any technical question. Our local office will answer you very quickly. Or if you have some question more commercial, or if you want to try the software, don't hesitate to contact us with contact@elis.fr or directly to our local office. Thank you very much, and yes, don't hesitate to contact us by email or by phone. Thank you very much. Bye.